Hey everybody, it's Wednesday, time for some Wisdom Wednesday. Thought I would record this while I'm doing a little snow therapy. I know that everyone hopefully is getting back on track back home in Dallas and the Metroplex area, trying to get situated with cleanup and recovery and then these crazy temperatures. Now it's spring and who knows what's gonna happen next. Anyway, I hope you all are well and have survived everything. I came up on Saturday and have been, like I said, doing a little snow therapy. It's been great. Just thought I'd give you a little bit of a look of the view that I have. I'm in Breckenridge, Colorado. And this week we are going to continue with our discussion on insulin resistance, from normal metabolism through insulin resistance all the way to diabetes. I just wanted to look at stage one, but before we do, I just kind of want to review some of the things about what insulin is and what it does, just real quickly. So remember, insulin is that type of hormone that is building. It's an anabolic hormone. And as such, it helps send glucose and amino acids and free fatty acids into the cells so that we can store this for energy as we need to, or use it for energy as we need to. So it is what is called anabolic. It's building up, not tearing down, the opposite of which is catabolic. Also, it promotes the dilation of our blood vessels so that we tend to have less issues with blood pressure. But of course, the opposite would be true. As we develop resistance to that insulin, we might run into some things with blood pressure issues, in particular what we see as we age in high blood pressure starting to happen for folks. So now we've talked a little bit about that, and insulin also, what it does is it decreases the liver's ability to make glucose. So it kind of turns off what is called gluconeogenesis, the making of new glucose, because we always want to have a supply of glucose for the brain. Now the brain can live on ketones, but in many instances, we've got to have a supply of glucose at all times so our liver is able to make glucose. It can also store it in the form of glycogen, and that's what it does when all of this energy comes in. Now, as we look at progressing from normal metabolism to stage one, very little changes other than the fact that too much energy is coming into the body. And as such, we don't really have much knowledge as within ourselves of what is going on when we bring too much energy in. But underlying all of that is the beginnings of insulin resistance, what we would call stage one. So at first, what happens is we bring in all this energy and we bring in too much. Let's say we just have a huge carb-laden meal and too much energy comes in. Well, what happens is the body increases insulin levels in order to manage all of that excessive energy or fuel coming into the body. So we have higher insulin levels after we eat, or what we call postprandial insulin. Now we still have a normal fasting blood sugar, so not much has really changed there. So when you come in to see me and we do some labs for you and we check our fasting blood sugar and we check fasting insulin levels, the only thing there that's really changed is you might start to see a tiny bit elevation in fasting and insulin levels, but we really don't see much in terms of what we find in our laboratory work that we do annually on most of our patients. And there's not really a significant amount of weight gain yet, because the energy is still being used within the muscle and other lean body tissues. Triglycerides are still normal. They have not gone up yet. And blood sugars essentially remain normal. So stage one really is not much going on other than we begin to start seeing a higher intake of fuel. And as we progress in the next few weeks and look at this change from normal metabolism all the way to diabetes, just know that there's this continuum. There's not just this abrupt moment when you become a diabetic. It's all a continuum. So all of this is a progressive type of process in the body. And it's really important to know these things, because what can affect this type of progression in terms of going to insulin resistance, and what then are the consequences of, what are these, the physiologic effects of all that? And what we know, and one of the things that we always check every year, is your lipid panel. And we know that over time, with abnormal bringing in of too much fluid, of too much fuel, we know that over time, you're going to see some increases in your triglycerides and your LDL cholesterol and lowering of that HDL cholesterol. We also begin to see that truncal obesity, that what we call visceral obesity, the internal fat stores start to surge. We know that blood pressure goes up, resting heart rate goes up, decrease in what we call heart rate variability, or that ability of your heart to sense breathing in and out, and having a healthy heart rate variability is very paramount to just health in general. We also begin, of course, to see the glucose intolerance. You don't manage to do well when you bring in loads of glucose. And we also begin to see dysfunction in the lining of our blood vessels. So all of these things are the physiologic effects of this continuum of bringing in too much fuel, particularly in the form of carbohydrates. So I hope you've enjoyed this little view back here. There have been some other sounds and things going on around. I hope it hasn't been too disturbing. I'm going to finish up today with a little bit of my slopes experience this morning as I was coming down Centennial at Breckenridge. So I hope you enjoy that as well. Next week, we will move on to stage two. And if you all have any concerns or questions, I know this is kind of nerdy, and I know that this information seems a little too much in terms of scientific information, but I think it's important to know, how do we get to these things that happen in our lives? And if you know some type 2 diabetics, you know that this is something that has progressed over years. This is not something that just happens overnight. And unfortunately, in many instances in traditional care, really no one intervenes until you are considered a diabetic. And there's just no reason not to try to reverse these changes. So hope you all have a great day. Enjoy my little ski down the mountain this morning, and we will talk again next week.